My uncle works for dispatch in my town, and he recently told my family of the weirdest call he's ever gotten. He says that he received a call from a landline one night, and when he answered it, it was only static on the other end. This happened two more times. Finally, he calls a squad to go and check out the address from the caller ID. When the cops got there and walked into the house, they immediately saw that there was a dead body. The person had been dead for 5 months. The craziest part about it was there was no electricity or any other utility working, so there's no way they should have been able to get those calls in a dispatch. But if they hadn't, who knows how long that person's body would have stayed there. It was Christmas Eve night, and I answered a call from a hysterical lady who was crying so hard she couldn't breathe. I asked her what was going on, and she told me these exact words. "My boyfriend and I were watching a movie. I fell asleep. I woke up and he wasn't here." I thought this was a little odd, so I said, "Okay, ma'am, do you know where he may have went?" She wasn't done. She said,
"I found him in our closet. He hung himself with our bed sheets."
I walked her through cutting him down and starting CPR, when in the middle of it, he starts making this long raspy exhale that sounds exactly like something from a horror movie. It's the rest of his air leaving his lungs. She starts getting hysterical again and begging him,
"Oh my God, he's breathing. Please breathe, baby. Please breathe."
But I knew that's not what he was doing. Police, fire, and ambulance got there, and of course, the guy was dead. I felt so bad for that woman. That's really the only call that has ever stuck with me. I worked dispatch for a total of 3 months, and in that 3 months, I only received one call that I won't describe as creepy. It was the voice of a little boy, and I was trying to be calm because it felt like he was having a hard time breathing. I asked him if he was in danger, and he said no, not anymore. I asked him why he had called, and he said,
"Well, the man in the attic finally killed my mom."
I asked him if he could still see his mom, and he said,
"No, the man took her to the moon."
I asked him if he was alone in the house, to which he replied,
"No, I still have the man's dog here."
I asked him what the dog's name was, in the hopes I could keep him calm. And the little boy replied,
"His name is Shaitan."
I asked him to say it again, thinking he said Satan, but he clearly replied with Shaitan. By the end of the call, the police showed up, and I still don't know whatever happened with the boy and his mother. But years later, I was researching the Jinn, and according to ancient texts, evil spirits like Jinn are able to manifest themselves as a dog or other animals. And guess what the Jinn were known as? Shaitan. I still have a hard time sleeping at night when I think about this call. I was a 911 call taker around 10 years ago when I received one of the creepiest calls ever. Around 3 a.m., my call box popped up green, and as usual, I asked what was the emergency. A man started frantically screaming that his sister was possessed by a demon and tried to cut his heart out while he slept. He had ran when the attack started, and locked himself in his bathroom. I asked him a series of questions, trying to figure out what the hell was going on. Every time he tried to answer, I heard what sounded like scratching and banging on the door. He whispered,
"There's a demon in my sister's body. It's been battling me for days. It got free from the chains."
I swear, what I heard next chilled me to the core. This unearthly voice began taunting my caller through the door. It didn't sound like a 20-something woman. It was low and guttural, like she had gargled razor blades before speaking. She continued to growl and speak in a strange-sounding language until police arrived. She let out a terrifying scream when the officers broke in, and then the call went dead. I sat there, shaking. I had to know what happened. Even my supervisor, who had been listening to the call in real time, was pale and speechless when the line abruptly ended. Before my shift was over, my commanding officer called in to tell me what they had found. He told me that he would have nightmares for the rest of his life. Apparently, When my caller said that his sister had got out of her chains, he wasn't joking around. She still had a chain tied to a bloody handcuff when the officers came in. Her whole body was covered in self-inflicted scratches. Her one eye had popped a blood vessel and was bright red. Most of what she was wearing was also shredded, and her skin looked like she had been drained of her blood. She was taken in for a psych consult, and as you probably guessed, she stayed in for a long time. The brother was okay, except for deep gouges in his chest. His sister had literally tried to dig out his heart. There was some talk about arresting the brother, but nothing ever came of it. I still can vividly remember that voice, and it still makes my blood run cold.